It's always a pleasure to introduce the used car market report at this event. Now, today, in reality, I only have a couple comments, and I'm only going to comment on four of the sections of the report, namely leasing, rental, repossessions, and of course, since we're here at NADA, dealers. But, you know, those of you that know me know that I'm going to talk about dealers regardless of the venue. Now, the report itself, the full report, of course, has other sections. There's an overview of overall remarketing, international, commercial fleet, and salvage. Since this is a press conference, in just a couple of minutes, you're going to have the opportunity to ask questions about any of those subjects. The full report also has my annual review and outlook piece. I'm not going to comment on that because I'm hopeful that you will actually read it. I mean, come on, it's only 1,938 words. Okay, first off with leasing. And I'll tell you the truth, I was a little reticent to even talk about leasing because it's a subject which has been so well covered by the very people in this room. And sometimes you're nice enough to quote me, I thank you. But I should make just a couple comments about leasing, a couple of facts and a couple of opinions. Fact. New vehicle lease originations after cyclical trough in 2009 totaled only 1.1 million units. New vehicle originations, new lease originations last year were 3.2 million units. So fact, that's an increase of over 2 million units in a four-year period. Fact, new lease originations inevitably turn into end-of-term units. Duh. Fact. There are many analysts out there and some lessors who are concerned about the flow of off-lease volume this year destroying residual values. Opinion. I think they're focused on the wrong year. They should be focused on 2016 when the volumes are going to be much, much higher, and we cannot be guaranteed that the retail environment will be as favorable that year as it is this year. Chances are it won't be. And let me close with one more opinion on leasing. The lease penetration rate is not too high. It is too low. I firmly believe that there are more people today in a long-term retail contract that should be in a lease as opposed to people in a lease that should be in a retail contract. Okay, the next subject is rental. Now, in 2013, the total rental fleet size grew by 5%. Total revenue grew by 4%. Therefore, the revenue per unit out there declined by 1%. But since acquisition and funding costs for rental car companies, which is an important factor, obviously, were at record lows, and since those rental cars that were sold at auction continued to command very high prices, fleet depreciation costs for the rental car companies were exceptionally low again last year. And because of that, they had record profits. Now, in the years coming ahead, I expect that the number of units going into the rental fleet and the number of units coming out will show small single-digit increases for the next couple of years. But the interesting point from my standpoint is if we look at the industry as a whole, the rental industry, you go back a decade, the industry as a whole and individual companies have had to tremendously change their business strategy. In some cases, turn it upside down. We've also had the tremendous consolidation. Okay, after Hertz's consummation of the Dollar Thrifty deal in late 2012, obviously that consolidation play is over. The three rental car companies now own more than 90% of all the units in service. But what is more interesting is through their various brands, they actively engage and compete in every single segment of the rental business, from on-airport premium brands to off-airport discount brands, from renters who are business people versus leisure and travel versus insurance replacement. And also interestingly, each one of the companies is actively engaged in international, and they have much more than just their toe in the water in terms of car sharing. Now, with respect to remarketing, the interesting thing I think going on in rental is the fact that you have a much wider, diverse mix of vehicles coming in and out of the fleet every year. And the swings between makes and models can be quite dramatic. That has helped, number one, the diversity of the mix, has helped support residual values. since you're not flooding the market with one particular model. But it makes it much more important that the rental car companies as remarketers understand that they get that particular model in front of the right buyer the first time. It's also important that other remarketers understand what those ebbs and flows of particular models are going to be because they're competing against them. Okay, the third one was repossessions, but in reality, I'll just make a couple of comments about the credit industry. As we've said in past years, and we can still say it again this year, there's no way that you can overestimate how important the availability of retail financing has been in terms of supporting used vehicle values, retail sales, and dealership profits. It has been very, very favorable, and I think it continues to remain favorable. And here again, I was a little scared about what I was going to say here today because earlier this week, I had the opportunity to address the American Financial Services Association, and I actually, and this is unusual for me, I spoke for an hour on credit risk and collateral risk. So I thought once I start getting into this, it might go a little long. We don't want to do that. So I'll just give you a couple of the takeaways and the, you know, some things I put maybe a little too loosely, but in reality, you know, if you look at the financing market today for automobiles, what you have, and we won't get into the reasons why, but, you know, Wall Street is throwing money at the lenders. The lenders are throwing money at dealers. So the dealers sell a used car because they have to have something to attach that note to. In reality, what we've gotten to in this situation is that, you know, we are making longer-term loans with a lower down payment to people with lower FICO scores, which is not exactly a prescription for success in terms of auto lending. But us old people also have seen this movie before. We know how it ends. But I say we've already paid the price of emission, so we should play it out to the end. And 2014, I think, has continued to be favorable. As a matter of fact, yesterday, Dan Burks with GM Financial explained it very, very well. He says, when we have our problem is when the lenders have this credit cycle and get aggressive, and that simultaneously clashes with the economic cycle. Well, certainly lenders are getting aggressive, but it's not going to yet clash with the economic cycle. So I'm positive with that respect. Okay, the final one is, of course, dealers. And again, just a couple comments, because I think we sum it up very well in the first line of the section dealing with dealers. 2013 was a great year to be a dealer. Whether you were a franchise dealer, an independent dealer, buy here, pay here dealer, or a wholesaler, it was a great time to be a dealer. I think it will continue to be so in 2014. There are certain segments of the market, like certified pre-owned sales, which hit a record in 2012, 13. I pretty much guarantee CPO sales are going to hit a record this year again. So it is good. It is a good market. And I'll just close with this. As you've already seen, you know, Manheim and the Auto Trader Group, we do a lot of products, services, and tools for dealers, which they quickly adapt to because they are competitive and they are innovative, and most of them like to sort of be on the cutting edge. And so they adapt to it. But when I was thinking about this, I thought to myself, you know, there is one thing that we do not do for dealers. We do not personally drive a high-quality vehicle to their door and give them an exclusive right to buy or not buy that vehicle at market value and then suggest to them maybe they want to sell us another vehicle. We don't do that. But I think you all know who does do that. An end-of-term lease customer. 2.1 million of those transactions are going to occur this year. 2.5 million next year. Over 3 million in 2016. And that's a fact. So with that, let's entertain any comments or questions you have. And I don't think they'll be directed to me because I talk to you all the time. So please, anything you might like to add. Thank you.